canopy that goes across the boat, obviously, so it doesn't fill with water. But the legs and the abdominal muscles are working pretty hard, aren't they?
You use your abdominal muscles a lot, like especially in these moves where you come across stoppers and waves. You've got to really hold your posture and keep your weight really neutral to maximise on what.
And how do you train for that? You do land training as well, presumably. You're in the gym, maybe?
Yeah, we do a fair bit of gym training in the winter, and I mean most of us continue it throughout the year, like certainly through racing, but a bit less. Do your sit-ups as normal and your chins. And
good stuff. Well, I was asking Helen just a little bit earlier. She's got the bronze medal. Is that it? And go on, tell everybody what you told me.
I think I said no. I was here to win a gold medal, and you know, I'm pleased with the bronze for my performance two days ago. It was good, you know, to win a bronze medal, but certainly I want that gold.
You haven't said what you tell me. You said you want to dominate.
I want to dominate, yeah.
Well, Kadelja, he was in the lead earlier on up the course, but now swinging across three gates to go, and like so many people, finding that swirling bit of water there between 17 and 18, a real problem, and he's got more problems here. Well, he's all over the place, the pressure of the situation. I know we talk about pressure ever such a lot in canoe. You won't see that very often, or we talk about it a lot in sport, but there is real pressure here. You've got a long time to get warmed up and to think about what it is you're hoping to do, and when it doesn't come off, boy oh boy, there's a massive anticlimax. So Kadelja at the moment, the Slovenian, is in third place behind Scott Parsons of the USA and Warwick Draper of Australia. The next guy, well known to all kayakers and paddlers, David Ford of Canada. I think you know him quite well, don't you?
Yeah, he's a really cool guy, and he seems to like to make it quite tough for himself in qualification, as shown last year at the World Championships in Augsburg, Germany. He struggled to qualify, but then ended up with the medal, so see what he can do.
So David Ford of Canada, 37 years old. He's been around for a long time. World champion back in 1999 in Spain. It's a pretty good time that's been set by Scott Parsons of the United States. No penalties on either of his two runs, the Americans, so 194.76. But let's just keep an eye out for the checkpoints. You're not going to stay with us for very much longer, because obviously you want to go away and watch the run of Campbell. What will Campbell be doing right now? David Ford's got a problem and slowed up there, but what will Campbell be doing just leading into the last few moments before the off?
I mean, I'm pretty sure he'll be like paddling around the warm-up channel and like just going through his run and his head and trying to keep cool, I think.
Well, actually, the Canadian has gone into the lead 1.22 seconds ahead of Scott Parsons of the United States after a little incident higher up there that really looked as though it could have made a right mess of his run down these swelling waters. But through 11, 12 and 13, pretty well. He's a real muscle man, this guy. He's got a tremendous upper body physique, hasn't he?
He certainly has. He's very, very strong, and it shows throughout his paddling. Campbell's been doing some training with him this last couple of weeks, and it's been quite interesting, because I think Campbell, you know, they're very different style of paddling between the two.
Well, there you go, from 17 to 18, once again, a real big stopper there where you're being hit full on to prevent you moving forward by a bow wave. And let's see if he can stay in the lead. He's gone through two check marks pretty quickly so far, and 2.18 seconds for the former world champion. David Ford of Canada is our new leader. And he was the fourth athlete to go down this course here on this K1 final. No guarantees, of course, that will win him a medal, but nevertheless, a very fine performance. So, Helen, one last question before you leave us. Obviously, many, many congratulations on your bronze medal. Are Great Britain going to get gold here today?
I really, really hope so, and I think it's very, very possible. So, fingers crossed for Campbell.
Absolutely. The next competitor, somebody who was tipped by Richard Fox, former world champion and British paddler, as a possible contender for the gold medal, Fabien Lefebvre of France. Well, you are going to stay with us to watch this fella. He's been around for a long time. His hero in sport is Lance Armstrong, and you can't argue with that, but has he got the potential?
Oh, he certainly has the potential. He's an amazing paddler, and it's very lovely to watch. He just very fluent, and he never really looks like he's trying that hard, which is kind of quite annoying because the rest of us are certainly trying pretty hard.
Just one last question. What about the form of the defending Olympic champion, Tomas Schmidt, who, of course, beat Paul Radcliffe of Great Britain in the last Olympic Games?
I think Thomas has been coming pretty strong this year. Like, he's had some really good races, and, he's a very strong athlete. So, let's just see what happens, really. It's hard to say. It's a funny race.
Well, it certainly is precarious, but desperately exciting. And Lefebvre of France, two penalty points on gate number three. He's down to 12 now. Swings around facing forward. One or two athletes have gone through backwards, of course, through 13. A massive amount of support for the Frenchman. There are, of course, two Frenchmen in this final group of 10. And Benoît Péchier is lying in second place at the moment behind Campbell Walsh of Great Britain. And that is good. 1.74 seconds ahead of Ford of Canada. So Fabien Lefebvre is having a great ride here. Just struggling a little bit to get through that last big stopper wave, but on now to the last two gates, trying to straighten up, just scrapes around the pole on gate number 19, and Shirley is going to go into the lead. Ah, got it, 192.11, only by 0.47 of a second, but that was very good, Helen, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was very good. I'm just keeping my fingers crossed that Campbell can beat it, really. Yeah. He's certainly got great support at home, and all the guys that I know that are watching in the regatta bar at home will be like shouting and cheering, and it's really hard. You never wish bad luck on anybody, but when your own competitors, when your teammates racing, you're watching every mistake.
Well, I know that you want to go off and watch him now, so thanks for being with us, and I'm sure you will see Campbell probably before any of us. Just say well done, whatever happens.
Certainly will. Thank you.
Thanks, Helen.
Hey.
So, just a few more competitors to go. Just looking on the computer here, we're at the halfway stage. Campbell Walsh, of course, because he was the fastest, goes last. This is the defending Olympic champion. He's an awesome competitor, Thomas Schmidt of Germany. He had two perfect runs in Penrith 4 years ago, and he beat Paul Radcliffe comfortably. Shame Paul Radcliffe not able to be here to defend his title. He thought he was going to qualify comfortably, but his World Cup season didn't go particularly well. He scraped into a second boat position for Great Britain, but unfortunately the British Canoe Union had to give up that place to the host nation, Greece. So desperately disappointing for Radcliffe. But Thomas Schmidt of Germany, he produced two perfect runs 4 years ago. He was untouchable in the K1 category, considered by many to be the blue ribbon event of canoe kayaking. And just a reminder, of course, that Great Britain have never won a gold medal in this competition or any of the categories. Women's K1, men's C1 and C2, and of course this event. Going down now through 12. Going to be very interesting to see how Schmidt's Czech time compares with the leader at the moment, Fabien Lefebvre of France. It's very different winning a title and then defending it successfully. Clock ticking away, he's going to be close, just outside, oh no, he's just inside, 0.41 of a second, and a massive cheer has just gone up from the grandstand. Swings across now, almost gets buried by the surf there, through 18, oh, and he's got a problem. He had to go through 360 degrees there, so losing valuable time, and the advantage may well have been lost. The defending champion, Thomas Schmidt of Germany, comes through and is outside of the time set by Lefebvre. The graphic's not working perfectly. He's putting his arms up saying, where am I in terms of places? But the computer tells us, in fact, he's down in third place behind David Ford and Fabien Lefebvre of France. Well, a bit of drama there. He was leading at one stage, and then it all went wrong for Thomas Schmidt on gate number 18. Of course, this being a man-made course, gates 17, 18, 19 deliberately put there by the organizers. They knew it was going to be very tough because of the flow of the water and the passage across an enormous swirling mass of water that almost brings you to a grinding halt. Grzegorz Polacek of Poland is next, 94.74, his original time. It gets carried over. He's ahead of the Olympic champion only just. So I wonder if Thomas Schmidt is going to be outside the medals. Polacek coming down now towards gate number three. trying to keep the acceleration that he produced from number two to number three going, but then you have to bring the brakes on rapidly to swing away and go upstream up four. There's three upstream gates in the first seven, and that is very physically demanding, apart from the technical side of the kayak. And he just ducked to one side there. As long as you've got a shoulder and your head through the gate, that is fine. No penalties. So the split time, 1:38.04, and he's outside that by not by a lot. So going pretty well at the moment. The pole dives down. It's a drop of about a meter there. And you have to not go hurtling through that gate, otherwise you're going to miss number 12. And bring yourself back on track for number 13, and then the second last upstream gate. Now, has he made up any time since the first checkpoint? No, he hasn't. He's lost time, in fact. And that was a particular part of the course where Fabien Lefebvre was particularly quick, and he's almost come to a grinding halt there on 17, rushing across the water, being knocked sideways through 18, just ducking under it, and he's got a real problem here. He'd have to put on the brakes and drag himself back to make sure he didn't miss out on gate 19. He has got a 2-second penalty, however. So his challenge has gone, and it all happened over the last three or four gates. Not happy at all. So Polacek ranked in fifth place currently. No chance of a medal. Campbell Walsh, of course, for Great Britain, will be the very last competitor to go in just a few moments' time. So a couple of mistakes really cost the pole dearly there. Such tension around the stadium for the last few. Now this man had an absolute flyer at the beginning of qualifying for the semi-final and final stages. He led for such a long time. Sam Uyd of the Netherlands. After the first run, he was lying in the bronze medal position. He's only ranked 31st in the world this year, but that first run at this Olympic semi-final was enough to put him in touch. Only about 0.75 of a second behind the leader, Campbell Walsh of Great Britain. So, oh, he's got a 2-second penalty there, just a little bit over-anxious. And Campbell Walsh will be getting ready now for his final run in just a couple of minutes' time. There's one more athlete to go, Benoit Petier of France, and then Walsh, the very last competitor in this last event at the Olympic Kayak Kalu Slalom Centre for the Olympic Games 2004 in Athens. Sam Uyd of the Netherlands putting his bid in for a medal, having been in the bronze medal position from the start. Drifting there underneath gate number 12 and having to put on the brakes pretty sharply before swinging round to take 13. This is one of the biggest paddlers in kayaking at the moment. He's over 6 feet tall, very heavy as well, so real powerhouse, and he needs that power in abundance at the moment. 1.31 seconds away from the lead, which is still French and Fabien Lefebvre. So he's got a bit of work to do. If he can go through 18, 19 and 20 swiftly, he could pick up a bit of time. Oh, he almost missed 19 there. We're looking directly onto number 19. He was only centimeters away. So he's dropped a lot of time. 1:97.28 outside of the medals after a brilliant first run. And currently the Dutchman is in sixth place. We're getting towards the end, the climax of this K1 final. Two competitors to go. Benoit Petier of France, a tantalizing 0.25 of a second behind Campbell Walsh of Great Britain. And leading at the moment is Fabien Lefebvre of France. David Ford, 37 years old, the Canadian, is in second place. And Thomas Schmidt, the defending champion, is still hanging on in there for a bronze medal at the moment. But here goes Benoit Petier. He was very, very good on the first run. Petier, no penalties, 93.93. If he could repeat that performance, it would be remarkable. Campbell Walsh is capable of massive speed on this course here. Petier just turning there, one, two, and he's through. That is exactly what Helen Reeves was talking about when she was in the commentary box. Just two efforts required to go through the upstream gates and away then into the middle of the course as he heads toward number six. So no penalties for Pechier, and the first split time will tell us whether he's going to challenge Lefebvre, his teammate, with a time to play with by the looks of it. Surely he's going to be inside. Yes, he is. 1.81 seconds, and the crowd are going potty now. That has come up on the giant screen, so it's France potentially in first and second place. Swings around through 12. Oh, made a bit of a mistake there. Almost went sideways onto the gate, but managed to get the oar in and just give it enough propulsion to swing the point through the gate. The second checkpoint is crucial. Has he lost any time on Lefebvre? 1.36 seconds again, so he's maintained his advantage. There is only Campbell Walsh of Great Britain to come to challenge for the gold medal in K1 canoeing. And at the moment, it looks as though Benoit Pechier is going to go into the lead, and he could lead by quite a long way. 187.96. That was 94.03 seconds. Not as fast as either he did or Walsh did on the first run. But that is Lefebvre, and it is France, currently in the gold medal position and silver. Benoit Pechier absolutely delighted. Just one competitor to go, and he's British. Well, goodness only knows what is going through the mind of Campbell Walsh. He is a very cool customer. And the British team out here with their coaching staff of John Anderson, the director, Oliver Fix, Kevin McHugh and the rest. I'd be surprised if they've got any fingernails left at all. That's David Ford in the background. He's been pushed down to the bronze medal position behind the two Frenchmen. Campbell Walsh goes for Great Britain. This is a gold medal run. This course holds no fear for Walsh. Born in Glasgow, now studying for a master's degree in information technology in Nottingham. Of course, the National Water Sports Centre at Home Pier Point, such an important ingredient of the success of the British team, and they have had a good Olympic Games. It all started off with Stuart McIntosh. Then, of course, Helen Reeves won her bronze medal in the women's K1. To be on the course somewhere, cheering. A bit of a problem there for Campbell. He was almost thrown sideways, and the graphics are not showing any penalties at the moment. There should be a little marker there showing whether any penalties are being given or not, but let's have a look on the split time. We've lost the split time. He's actually 0.89 of a second outside of Pechier's split time at the first checkpoint, so he's got to go fast. He's got to throw caution to the wind. He is quite a cautious competitor, but he's got no fear. He's very, very strong, and he's got to whistle down this course now. Otherwise, the gold is gone. Two more upstream gates to go, so the muscles will be burning. Campbell Walsh going for Great Britain through 16 now. And 2.2 seconds he's dropped. This is not good news for Campbell Walsh. And at this rate, he could potentially be out of the medals, but he's got to keep it going. Going across to 18 now. The sprint is on. Coming through 19. This is where he did so well yesterday. Trying to maintain as much speed as possible. What is it going to be for Campbell Walsh? He's in third place. It's a bronze medal. And you can tell from that reaction just what he thinks about that. He came here to win gold. He's got a medal. Great Britain will get on the medal rostrum and on the medal table once more, but is not the colour he wanted. Gold and silver go to France. Benoit Pechier is the champion. Fabien Lefebvre is the silver medalist. And Campbell Walsh is the bronze medalist. They can't believe it, the French contingent. They really can't. And just looking at Campbell's time, it was desperately slow in comparison to what he achieved yesterday and today. As the Frenchmen take a well-earned dip, I think we could all do with that after this competition, such as the atmosphere being. Campbell's time, 97.48. No penalties, but when you compare that with the 93.68 on the first run, well, different class the Frenchmen were in the end. But that is another medal for Great Britain. Let's be fair about this. Helen Reeves set the standard when she won a bronze medal in the K1 competition. Stuart McIntosh finished in eighth place in his C1 competition. Stuart Bowman and Nick Smith desperately disappointed everybody, including themselves, of course, by finishing in ninth place in the C2 category. But there is confirmation of the K1 result. Gold goes to France. Benoit Péchier. Fabien Lefebvre, his teammate and friend, gets a silver, and Great Britain, through Campbell Walsh, gets the bronze medal. The defending champion, Thomas Schmidt, finished outside the medals, Schmidt finishing in fifth place. He was the guy who beat Paul Radcliffe in this category 4 years ago in Sydney. There's going to be a massive celebration by the French, that is obvious, and I just wonder by the time Susie Perry catches up to Campbell Walsh, how much time he's had to reflect on actually what he has achieved as opposed to possibly what he might have achieved. Well, we're going to find out. Let's join Susie Perry.
Campbell Walsh, a bronze medal today. That was a really tough call.
Very disappointed, really. I didn't really attack it. I thought I was going quite fast. I thought the commentator said I was a gate 16. I thought I heard him say I was well up. So I took it a bit steady over the last few gates. Shouldn't have done that.
So yeah. where do you feel as though you lost the time?
Well, a little bit here and there. I thought I had it too easy. I thought I could kind of cruise. I take it easy and get the win. But I guess not.
But it's a bronze medal, it's an Olympic medal, Campbell. Yeah. I know you want your gold, but you'll still be standing on the podium with that medal.
Yeah, it should be fun.
And you've still got years to go.
Yeah, maybe.
What's going through your mind at the moment?
I don't know, I kind of want to know what my time was and stuff like that for my run.
We're going to have a look at split time.
Yeah.
A little bit down in the first one and then the second one also.
Yeah.
97.48.
Right. That's not very good, that's pretty rubbish. Because in 93 with a massive mistake on my first one, that's really slow. Oh, I must have been really steady on all of it. Oh, I wasn't very nervous, I didn't attack it enough.
Did you feel it was quite difficult to get going?
No, it felt alright. I thought my boat was running fast, but I guess it wasn't.
And when you're going around, because you said you heard the commentators, can you actually hear the crowd? Can you hear the supporters?
On the back straight you can hear it a bit. But you can't make out particular voices, but you can make out little bits.
Okay, well, it's a bronze medal. I know you're disappointed, but you're a medal around your neck, Cameron. Well done.
Public address commentator French, I wonder. It was the French who came through in that final round. Campbell Walsh got us all excited for a while. It's Benoit Péchier of France who takes the gold. And it's another medal for Britain, Campbell Walsh with the bronze. Well, all that has been getting us rather excited. The athletics has been continuing.